What has been the biggest test for you, do you think, if there was like one instance where you really felt your faith, your will be tested?
How far am I really willing to go to get the message across? Simple example. This is my second album on the mainstream commercial level. Now, just simple as this. Me making the decision to make this album is just as simple as, or just as hard as, or however you want to put it, is me making an actual commercial album full of hit records. Mm-hmm. That right there is the temptation right there. You feel what I'm saying? This is your second album supposed to be the blowout, you know, and you want to have these type of radio records. But for the simple fact saying I want to do it my way, and I want to continue the message getting off on this album with so much expectation, it shows a lot of courage and a lot of integrity, you know, and I think that was one of my ways.
Because you get to compare to Nas a lot, I think, on Good Kid, Mad City, just because y'all debuts were so strong. His was Illmatic. And it was written was kind of his, all right, I'm going to be with Lauryn Hill, we're going to do the big radio records. Yeah. And a lot of people wondered early on if that's where you were going to go. And you went your own way. It's commendable because you could have done that. And I think we would have been fine with that. I think we would have enjoyed that as well.
Yeah. But for me, I like to pace myself, man. I like to look at longevity. And believe me, everything is strategically.
Yeah. Like, I wouldn't have been mad at another Michael Jordan record. Yeah. I'm just saying.
Yeah. everything. You know, I got to pace myself, and I felt like it was only right that we give him this record.
Real. Black of the Berry.
Oh, yeah.
Another one of them songs, when you get to the end, you have to rewind. In the first two verses, you set us up. There's anger, there's angst. I mean, you're giving it to the establishment for how black people are treated in this country and how, you know, stereotyped. In the third verse, you just flip it. And you point the scope. Back. You caught a little bit of flack. Who are you speaking to on that third verse?
I'm glad you asked that question. For me. You feel what I'm saying? I think a lot of people get confused and thinking, I'm not going to even say a few people think it's just talk and it's just rap. No. These are my experiences. When I say gang banging made me kill a nigga blacker than me, this is my life that I'm talking about. I'm not saying you might not even be from the streets.
Not every black person is in a gang.
Not in the gang.
Has that experience.
I'm not speaking to the community. I'm not speaking of the community. I am the community. My homeboys, those are my real homeboys on my album cover. They still over there. You know, no matter how much I want to bring them back and take them to other places, they still embody that, you know, that's them. So when I say these lines, it's for myself. This is therapeutic for myself because I still feel that urge and I still feel that anger and that hatred for this man next door because I got to get a call knowing that somebody around the corner done did this to my partner. I still feel that. I still feel that hatred. I still feel that ill will to want it to do something.
Do you have that in you? Do you feel like you have that in you?
All the time.
Wow.
I've only been in this industry for 3-4 years, and I can't forget 20 years of me being in the city of Compton. So when I say these things, it's therapeutic for me. It's making me remind I need to respect this man because he's a black man, not because of the color that he wearing. That's what I mean. So I say this all the time. For people who take that out of context or take anything I say out of context, and I'm not even blaming the magazines. I'm blaming the people listening to it or reading it. Know who I am first. Understand where I come from before you make any remarks. Because I've been through a lot and I've seen a lot. And it's where good. I come from, we I've done a lot to tear down my own community.
Wow.
So for you to not recognize that and see 100% flip, please learn it.
Right. It's good, and I'm glad. Thank you for sharing that. I mean, because when I saw the little bit of criticism, it did feel like, well, this is a brother who's been thoughtful with his music and his message. So maybe there's more to it.
Oh yes.
You know, like we owe him that much. So I'm glad you was able to clarify that.
Yeah, my thing is this too. We so quick to tear down our leaders, man.
Right. We're gonna get to that.
That's scary to me, bro. That's really scary, bro.
Because we're gonna get to Mortal Man. I think a lot of that's on Mortal Man. We're gonna get that. I got two more songs with you. I'm gonna be honest. When I first heard I loved it.
Right.
I was like, this is it. This is right. This feels right. When I got to it on the album, I'm on Twitter and I'm actually live tweeting as I'm hearing it on my way to work. Yeah. And it was the live version, and I'm like, wait.
I hate when they do it live because I be hating it too.
I was like, why'd he do this? And I'm tweeting out loud. I'm gonna keep it 100. Ebro from Hot 97 then try to get at me on Twitter for because you don't understand. I'm like, slow down, bro. Listen, so I'm tweeting it. Why did Kendrick use this live version? Right. I don't like this live version. Until I get to the end. And when it wraps up, I'm like, I understand. I get it now. Where you break up the fight in the crowd. Mm-hmm. And you kicked the freestyle. Why did you choose the live version and not the studio version of I?
That was my ideal idea for the album, even when I made the record. I already knew what I wanted to do. I already knew I wanted to, it have to be cohesive with the conceptual part of the album. And I'm just huge like that, man. To be 100% real with you, I see things as scenes in movies. You know, when I write, so that becoming an actual play in a skit on an album is like second nature to me. Right. I'm already knowing how I want to convey it. Even if it won 2 Grammys and things like that, it's still going to go on an album my way. And I'm glad it got across like that. I knew a lot of people would be like, what is he doing? Why is it like this? But it plays in a part going into Mortal Man the way I hear it.
Right, and it was dope because you actually get to see the message in action. Not only are you saying, I love myself, you then get to touch the crowd and show them why they should love themselves.
Yeah.
You get into that freestyle at the end, which is dope because you take the N-word and you break it down in a way I've never heard before. Niggas, N-E-G-U-S, and you connect it back to Ethiopian, a word that means royalty. Are you gonna reclaim the word? Is this a step in kind of reclaiming the N-word and all the negativity that goes with it and put a positive twist? Because we've been trying to do that
for centuries. We've been trying to do it for sure, you're right. And it still never translate, you know, peas into the ear. But this is a start, and that was the purpose for it. And I gotta give all credit to my partner, Taz Arnold, because so many times, this is a guy that's pivotal in the studio sessions as well. He did You, Lucy. But most of the times, it's not even about us making music. It's about us just having conversational pieces. Right. You know what I'm saying? A lot of the inspiration comes from that. And he was one of the first that brought this to my attention. You know, it's been under our nose for years. Right. You feel what I'm saying? It's been our nose, but we all are kings at the end of the day.
I had to look it up. Like, it forced me to go and research, because I was like, I know with you, it's never just rap. Some dudes is just rap and it sound good. Mm-hmm. I was like, wait, what?
Yep.
And I had to look it up.